All right, so now we'll continue with tutorial number 4, manometer. And the manometer connects two pipes shown in figure below. The pressure in pipe B is 3.5 kilopascal. If the fluid properties and manometer orientation are shown in the figure, determine the pressure in pipe A. Okay, so the question requires you to calculate the manometer calculation, and you have to see to check on the picture first before we continue with the calculation. Number one, pipe B will have a pressure of 3.5 times 10 to the power of 3 Pascal. Make sure you change it from kilopascal to Pascal, easier for us to calculate. And then in this part, we have oil, okay? If the fluid properties and manometer orientation are shown, okay. Another one over here that you need to check on is this part where we have the inclined manometer. So if this is an inclined manometer, we need to know what is the vertical height because it's very important for us to do the manometer calculation. To find out the vertical height for the inclined manometer, so incline manometer, we should use the theorem Pythagoras calculation. So this is 10 cm. This should be the height that we want, okay, for the gauge fluid, all right? And then the angle over here is 30 degree. To find out what is the height over here, should be sine 30 degree is equal to h divided by 0.1 meter. We convert it into meter, okay? So h should be equal to 0.1 sine 30 degree. So the answer should be 0.05. So H is equal to 0.05 meter. Okay. So when we are done with this, we know what is the H. So now we can do the calculation for manometer. Okay. So the calculation as usual is from, I'm using the idea of going from left to right. And PB is equal to PA, and PA is higher than the gauge fluid. So this is an addition of rho water G 0.07, okay, because it is 7 centimeter, okay, and then the starting point of the gauge fluid is lower than the ending point, so it's a minus rho gauge fluid G, and then we have the H over here, 0.05, okay, and then we have the final part, which is oil, also the starting point is lower than the ending point, so it's minus, okay. And then rho oil G 0.05. Okay. Now, what we need to do is we need to find out what is P in pipe A. Okay. So, pressure in pipe A. So, if you fill in the numbers inside here, PB is 3.5 times 10 to the power of 3 equals to PA. Plus rho water is 1000 multiplied by 9.81 0.07 and minus rho fluid, the gauge pressure is 13.6, the gauge fluid density is 13.6 times 1000 times 9.81 times 0.05 and then minus rho oil, which is 0.96 times 1000 times 9.81 times 0.05. Okay. So the answer should be 3.5 times 10 to the power of 3 equals to PA. Then okay, so the answer will be 3.5 times 10 to the power of 3 equals to PA minus 6454.98. Okay, so PA is equal to 3.5 times 10 to the power of 3 plus 6454.98. So PA should equal to 3.5 PA equals to 9954.98 pascal. Okay, so this should be the answer for the question. Okay, so remember, whenever you have a question like this, please make sure the pressure should be changed into unit pascal rather than kilopascal. And then number two, if you have an inclined manometer, make sure you change the inclined manometer and get what is the vertical manometer height over here. Because what we are dealing with on this side, okay, the manometer calculation requires you to know the vertical height rather than the inclined height. So if you do everything at the beginning, it's easier for you to just fit in the numbers inside in the calculation. All right. So this should be the last tutorial for today. And the tutorial for today is on manometer also, the last one, but a different picture. Just now, the manometer is inside a system where these two are pipes. Okay. And then we have some elevation here, incline condition here. But right now we have a condition where the manometer that has an opening on both ends. Okay, so I read up the question. A U-tube manometer with four different liquid has both ends open to the atmosphere. The pressure is provided here. PATM is equal to 101.325 kilopascal. Calculate the density of the unknown fluid rho f. This one. Okay, so the question asks you what is rho f and the pressure at point x, px. So this is another one that is asked by the question. Okay. So the density is given there for water 1000 kilogram per meter cube, mercury 13650, and for oil is 760 kilogram per meter cube. Okay, so this is a simple manometer question. For both ends, it's open to the atmosphere. So I just put one over here and two just as a guide for us so that we have point one and point two. Okay, so to continue with the calculation, first We just list out all the liquids that we have inside the manometer. Once again, I'm doing it from left to right. So P2 is equal to P1. And then P1 is higher than the density down here. So we can assume that this is a plus sign, okay? And this is raw fluid times G times 0.2 meter, okay? And then here we have water. The starting point is higher than the ending point. So we can get it as a plus sign also. Raw water, G 0.3 meter. And then here we have mercury. The starting is lower than the ending point. So we have it as a minus density of mercury times G times 0.15. And then last one we have H4 and density of oil. The beginning is lower than the ending. So it's a minus of rho oil G 0.5. Okay. So now we add in the numbers again. So to make sure everything is correct, we have to put in one by one. PATM for P2 and PATM for P1 should cancel out. Plus rho fluid is unknown. 9.81 times 0.2. Plus rho water is 1000. 9.81 times 0.3 and then minus rho mercury 13,650 times 9.81 times 0.15 and then lastly oil 760 kilogram per meter cube times 9.81 times 0.35. okay. So over here, zero is equal to, this is zero. So rho F multiplied by Okay, and then plus water. Over here, 2,943 minus the mercury. And then minus the oil. 2,609.46. Okay, to find out what is the density of the fluid. So density of fluid times 1.962 is equal to 19,752.44. So by dividing this number and this number, rho F should equal to 19,752.44 divided by 1.962. So this should be equal to 10,067.5 kg per meter cube. Okay, so this should be the answer for calculate the density of the unknown fluid rho F. Okay, we are not done yet because the second question asks us what are what is the pressure at point X, Px over here? So point X is here. So we may start from the left or we may start from this side to the right, but I'm using this side because we only have to find out these two calculation for these two parts, okay? Okay, so the second part of the calculation will be just point one up until Px. So we have the numbers for row F, so we can use that. Or if you want to be more secure, we can use row Px as the starting point and point two as the ending point. Why? Because we know the numbers here, so the answer should be more accurate. Because row F, if we have the wrong answer for row F, we will have the wrong answer for Px also. So it depends on you whether you want to use these two columns or you want to use this column on the right. So for me, to prevent any problem at the end, so I'm just going to use Px equals, sorry, I'm just going to use Px as the starting point and P2 as the ending point. So P2 is equal to Px, okay, and then minus rho mercury. Minus rho oil okay, so we have that. So to find out what is Px, P2 will still be PATM and Px will be minus 13,650 13,650 times 9.81 times 0.35. Okay, PATM is equal to 101325 Pascal. Okay, so if we do the calculation correctly, your Px should equal to 101325 plus this number here, we already have it on top, 20,000. And then plus 2609.46. Okay. So 101325 plus 20085.98. Plus 2609.46. So Px should equal to 020.44 Pascal. Okay. So this is the answer for the second part, which is the pressure at point X.